35 years ago, in the span of 3 hours and 10 minutes, Philip Kaufman showed us what heroes used to look like. The right stuff, based off the 1979 Tom Wolfe novel of the same name, is what happens when you put together the westerns of John Ford, the ingenuity of Stanley Kubrick's 2001, along with a layer of Frank Capra's sentimentality spread throughout. It is not only Kaufman's magnum opus, but also one of the all-time great American epics. Spanning 16 years, The Right Stuff focuses on the military test pilots played by a murderer's row of acting talent that included the likes of Scott Glenn, Dennis Quaid, Ed Harris, and Champ Shepard, amongst others. Men who were crucial to the success of the American air and space programs, starting with the breaking of the sound barrier in 1947, ending in 1963 with the launch of the Mercury Atlas 9, the last time an American would go on an orbital mission solo. Kaufman showed us the few triumphs and the many, 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 many failures of both the air and space programs, as well as the grueling days of training, both physical and mental, the 7 men who would take part in the space program would endure, all to risk their very lives to pierce the sky above us all. The Right Stuff is a very American movie. However, Kaufman, who also wrote the script, took care not to let the film veer off into becoming just American propaganda. He does so not only by showing the goofier sides of the American space program, but also by showing the men who take part in the mission as actual human beings. While they went along with the spectacle made around them, the Mercury 7 didn't really care about whether they got the attention or not. They were all guys who saw an opportunity to be a part of something special and took it. They wanted to do their jobs, do it well, look out for one another, and take care of their families. You don't have to be a man or an American to connect with that. The film was nominated for a number of Academy Awards, winning 4, which included Best Editing, which seeing the wonderful dissolves, smash, and match cuts Kaufman and his team of 5 editors compiled to put the film together, you wouldn't argue with that. And Best Score, which was done by the legend Bill Conti. The film has been referenced in countless media through the years, including one of my favorite episodes of The Simpsons, Deep Space Homer.
Now I'll bust that pretty face of yours! stupid bar!
And the iconic slow walk moment has shown up in both live action and animated films. Christopher Nolan has said that The Right Stuff was an inspiration for his 2013 film Interstellar, and I would be shocked, if that also wasn't the case for Damien Chazelle's newest film, First Man, where Ryan Gosling plays Neil Armstrong, who is about to embark on his mission to save jazz, go to the moon. A film this acclaimed and well-remembered should have been a box office hit, right? No. The film was a massive bomb. However, as with all great art, it stands the test of time. In 2013, it was entered into the National Film Registry. If you've never seen The Right Stuff or haven't seen it in a number of years, I implore you to seek it out. There has been so much said in the last few years of how hateful and divided we all are. And I think that no matter where you are or what you support, a viewing of The Right Stuff can remind all of us that together, and only together, there's no goal we can't accomplish, no task we can't endure, no heaven-like heights we can't reach.